This is Scott Freck, Executive Director of the Eugene Symphony. In an interview recorded at public radio station KLCC in downtown Eugene, I had a chance to catch up by phone with Inon Barnatan, who will be the soloist for our performance of Beethoven's Piano Concerto No. 4 on Thursday, October 16th. Inon, of course, is no stranger to Eugene audiences after previous visits here in 2009 and 2011. But this time around, he has a new title. He's now Artist in Association with the New York Philharmonic. I asked him what that meant and how he feels to be named to such a prestigious position at one of the world's greatest orchestras.
Yeah, I'm over the moon. Usually they bring somebody for a debut and then it takes several years until they come back, and it takes a long time until they both the orchestra and the audience develop a relationship with each other. And they thought, and I'm very happy they did, that it would be a great way to develop a relationship with someone from the get-go, to just hire them for three seasons and have them come and have a real deep and meaningful association, which is, I think, why they chose the slightly strange title.
I think it's a great title. Congratulations on it. So this must be a first for you to have this kind of deep and enduring relationship with one orchestra. Is it a first for them too?
Yeah, I'm the very first one. They have artists in residence, which comes for one season, does a lot of different things in one season. But this is the first time that they've done something like this, which is a multi-season relationship. They've done it with composer, but I think the very special thing here is that I haven't actually played with him yet. So it'll be my debut this season.
Oh wow! What are you playing?
The first year I'll be playing the Ravel G major concerto.
Wonderful.
And I'll also be playing some chamber music with them and so forth. And so it's really and with Alan Gilbert, their music director, which is also wonderful. So yeah, it's to be able to do that in my own city and my own backyard is also fantastic. And that it's New York is even better. So
congratulations. So
from
New York to Eugene, then this will be your third visit to Eugene since 2009. Each time working with, of course, our music director Daniel Rachev, and each time playing Beethoven. First time with the second piano concerto, and then the triple concerto with Chi Yun and Joshua Roman. First of all, what are you looking forward to with your return trip to Eugene this week? And second, what is about playing Beethoven with Daniel? Something must be working there for you two to keep doing Beethoven again and again.
Well, I'm sure I'm not alone in having a special fondness for Beethoven, and neither is Daniel. So I don't know. One of the things I'm very much looking forward to is coming back to Eugene. I love the orchestra and I love the city. All Beethoven concertos are great, but the Beethoven fourth concerto, which I'll be playing, is really, well, I hate to say my favorite, but it might actually be my favorite because it is the most lyrical, deep, joyful, sorrowful, everything. It's just the most phenomenal piece of music, the pinnacle of the concerto, piano concerto writing for him. And to be able to play that is always such a special thing. And it's nice to have played two different Beethoven pieces with the orchestra and with Daniel, and to be able to then turn to this masterpiece is very special.
Well, you might hate to say it, but I'll say it. It's absolutely my favorite of the five Beethoven piano concertos, and to be honest, it might be my favorite of all piano concertos. You mentioned that you think it's the pinnacle of Beethoven's piano concerto writing. Probably the Emperor might be more famous. So what is it about the fourth, in your view, and as a performer and as an interpreter of Beethoven, makes it so special?
Well, the Emperor is obviously a wonderful piece, and the slow movement especially of that piece is sublime. And but there is a something deeper for me about the fourth concerto. There's such amazing lyrical writing, and the relationship between the piano and the orchestra. The second movement of the fourth piano concerto is just stunning. It's most radical, almost thing. One of the most radical movements in this concerto writing. It's almost, people have compared it to the story of Orpheus and Eurydice, and the kind of Orpheus trying to coax the demons of hell to convince them to release his beloved, and eventually succeeding. I think it's a very appropriate comparison, even though Beethoven never admitted it himself.
I'm glad you brought up that second movement, Inon, because for me it really is the heart of the piece. I've heard the Orpheus reference before. For me, it reminds me of almost a nonviolent protest. You have the individual voice, the piano, that's sort of pitted against these violent outbursts of the orchestra, and gradually over time, the piano sort of, in its serene kind of way, wins the day and quiets the masses. Puts me in mind of a Gandhi or a Martin Luther King, a single voice.
Oh, that's interesting. Convincing
a horde of angry people to change their minds in a way.
Yeah, and at certain points, the pianist gives this very long and heartfelt speech in the middle of this movement. And at the end, the masses are left speechless. And it's a very special. There are no words to describe it, but it is a phenomenal piece of music.
Wonderful, Inon. Thank you so much. We look forward to the concert. See you soon.
See you soon. Thank you.
Pianist Inon Barnatan talking about the Piano Concerto No. 4 by Ludwig van Beethoven, which he'll perform with the Eugene Symphony on Thursday, October 16th at the Holt Center. More information can be found at eugenesymphony.org. This interview was recorded at public radio station KLCC in downtown Eugene. I'm Scott Freck, Executive Director of the Eugene Symphony, and thanks for listening.